Hello, graphics cell friends. Welcome to the channel that always brings the best solutions for your technology needs. In this video, we will discuss Android Utility Tool Pro V160.00.6666, from installation steps to the latest features that are very useful for technicians and mobile users. Make sure to watch until the end, as the duration is just right for those of you who want to learn in depth. First of all, let's discuss how to install this tool easily. Follow these steps, download the file. You can download the installation file via the link we have provided in the video description. Make sure your internet connection is stable to avoid file corruption during the download process. Extract the file. Once the download is complete, extract all contents to your desktop or the C:// directory. This extraction process is important to ensure the program runs smoothly without issues. Run the program. Open the application after the extraction is complete. The program loading process only takes a few seconds. If you encounter an error message like smart card error, it means you haven't connected the dongle to your computer. But don't worry, some features can still be used without a dongle. Connect your device. Connect your phone to the computer using a USB cable. Once the device is detected, select the function that suits your needs, such as bypassing FRP, fixing the bootloader, or others. With that, the tool is ready to use. Main features of Android Utility Tool Pro V160.00.6666. Now, let's discuss the features offered by this latest version. One of the most exciting updates is the tool's ability to work in Preloader mode. What is Preloader mode? In this mode, you don't need to press any boot keys or perform any hardware operations. This feature makes it easier for technicians to extract MTK hardware keys, such as RPMB keys, FDE keys, iTrusty, FBE, kilometer, keys, provision keys. However, it's important to note that this feature requires a special DA, download agent, file to work. Special appreciation goes to Bjorn Kurler, who successfully implemented the DXCC crypto API in this update.